We're given a point on the coordinate plane. Notice how the given red point has coordinates -5, 4. And we're asked to give the coordinates of the point if reflected across the x-axis, then if reflected across the y-axis, then if reflected across the origin. So to reflect the given point across the x-axis or the horizontal axis, we can think of folding the graph across the x-axis, or notice how the given point is 4 units above the x-axis. So once reflected across the x-axis, it would be 4 units below the x-axis here. So the reflected point here would have coordinates -5, -4. If we compare the coordinates of these two points, notice how when reflecting across the x-axis, the x-coordinates would be the same, but the y-coordinates would be opposites. So this point here would be -5, -4. Next, we want to give the coordinates of the point reflected across the y-axis. So now we can think of folding the graph across the vertical axis or y-axis, or notice how the given point is 5 units to the left of the y-axis. So once reflected across the y-axis, it would end up being 5 units to the right of the y-axis here. So notice, after reflecting the red point across the y-axis, the point would have coordinates +5, +4. So when reflecting a point across the y-axis, notice how the y-coordinates would be the same, but the x-coordinates would be opposites. So this point here would be 5, 4. Now for the last part, we want to give the coordinates of a point if reflected across the origin. To reflect a point across the origin, we want to reflect the given point across the x-axis and the y-axis, or we can also think of rotating the point 180 degrees about the origin. So notice how if we start with this given point, reflected across the x-axis, we know it would be here. But then if we reflect the point again across the y-axis, it would end up being 5 units to the right of the y-axis here. So if we reflect the given point across the origin, this would be the new point. Notice how the coordinates are -5, -4. So when reflecting across the origin, notice how the x-coordinates and the y-coordinates are opposites. Or as I mentioned before, we could think of taking the given point and rotating it 180 degrees about the origin. So to show this, if we sketch a segment here, and rotated the given point 180 degrees about the origin, notice how its new location would be here at the coordinates -5, -4. So to summarize what we've done here, I'll leave you with some notes on how to reflect a given point across the x-axis, y-axis, and the origin. I hope you found this helpful.